Software engineering and product management are two of the most popular and sought-after jobs in the tech industry right now. And for good reason. They both offer high compensation, have great work-life balances, and they do very interesting work. However, the two careers are quite different from one another. So, which one is the right fit for you? Today, we're going to cover a few things to help you make this decision. First, we're going to go over job descriptions and talk about what both careers actually do. Next, we'll then move into covering career paths. After this, we'll take a look at compensation, which is another very important factor in making a career decision. Following that, we'll be discussing work-life balance and other quality of life factors for each career. Lastly, we'll discuss market outlook, looking at the current state of each career in 2022, as well as taking a look at how these jobs might change in the future. At the end of this video, I will actually answer the question, should you be a software engineer or a product manager? Well, the answer is, of course, it depends. I'll give a few scenarios where you might want to choose one over the other to help you decide. With that being said, let's get right into comparing the job descriptions for each career. Software engineering is a lot more straightforward than product management, so I'll start with that. Software engineers are the backbone of many technology companies, and their primary job is to create the software for that company. You may think of obvious jobs like coding for Google's search engine and Instagram's mobile application, but software engineers do work in lots of different places, whether that's working on systems for large banks or working on operating systems for cars, airplanes, and other vehicles. Software engineers are specialists who primarily work with code. Typically, junior software engineers spend about 80% of their days working with code, whether that's writing code or testing it, etc., and the rest with meetings and other administrative stuff. Product management is not as clear-cut to explain, as responsibilities vary from team to team. So, we'll cover what product managers do in general, and then the varying responsibilities. The primary goal of a product manager is to ensure that the product they are working on is successful. This includes designing features that meet customer needs, facilitating efforts between all of the teams working on a product, and any other tasks required for a product to be successful in the market. As you can see, this is such an open-ended responsibility, and may require different skills from situation to situation, which is why it's a lot harder to describe exactly. Unlike software engineers, who are specialists in programming and primarily focus on that, product managers are generalists who have skills in various different areas and enjoy working in them all, from coding to marketing to design. Product managers and software engineers almost always work together, and product managers work for the same types of companies that software engineers do. When first starting out, junior software engineers mostly learn about the company's tech stack and code on teams with many other juniors and a few seniors. Juniors can expect promotions in their first 2 to 3 years if they are doing well and meeting the company's goals. Once promoted to a software engineer, you gain a bit more responsibility, and it's about the same 2 to 3 year trajectory to becoming a senior software engineer. Once you're a senior, you start becoming more specialized in your coding skill set, and you start to gain more exposure to additional company concerns, such as budgets. From here, there are two primary career paths: management and individual contribution. Seniors who want to move into engineering management will end up doing less coding and more management of teams. Seniors who don't like management and want to continue working as programmers become individual contributors and get promoted to roles such as principal software engineer, where they have a lot more coding responsibility and act as role models for the rest of their team, but don't have to do as many management. We'll talk about this in the next section, but both choices pay quite well, so this should not be a determining factor. The first title of a product manager can be junior product manager, associate product manager, technical product manager, or just plain product manager. This career path is a lot less defined, which can be a good thing or a bad thing. Successful product performance can cause juniors to rapidly promote through the ranks all the way up to the top, which is usually something like a principal product manager or a higher management role like director or vice president. There usually isn't a defined time period to promotion, so performance is important for promotions. Now moving into compensation, which might be what a lot of you are interested in. The truth is, both of these jobs can be extremely well compensated depending on title and company. I gathered my data from levels.fyi, which has a lot of great insights on how much each tech company pays for various jobs. One thing to keep in mind is that people self-report data, so it could in theory be skewed towards the upper end, although many professionals have said that the website is accurate, so take that as you will. We'll be comparing the various levels of both software engineering and product management, looking at both average compensation at each level, as well as how much the large tech firms pay. Also, this is an oversimplification of this entire process. There's a whole lot more to go into regarding compensation, so much so that we'll be making another video on it soon, so make sure to subscribe if you want to see those when they come out. We'll be using USD as a monetary figure, but you can convert to your own currency easily by searching it up. At the junior level, software engineers get paid around $90,000 on average, and product managers get paid around $85,000. At large tech firms, junior software engineers get paid quite a bit more at around $175,000 on average, and junior product managers get paid around $150,000. At the next level, software engineers get paid $110,000, and product managers get paid around $100,000. At large tech firms, software engineers get paid around $240,000 on average, and product managers get paid around $220,000. Moving to the senior level, software engineers get paid around $130,000 on average, and product managers get paid around $120,000. At the large tech firms, software engineers get paid around $315,000 on average, and product managers get paid around $300,000. At the next level, software engineers get paid around $150,000 on average, and product managers come in close at around $140,000. At large tech firms, software engineers are getting paid around $450,000, and product managers are getting paid just less at around $435,000. We could continue going up further, but the numbers really start to vary around here. 10 to 15 years in, the average software engineer is likely making around $175,000, with product managers trailing just behind at around $165,000. At large tech firms, there is huge disparity, as some engineers and product managers make into the high hundreds of thousands. At this point, however, career paths become very distorted, with potential moves into upper management and other shifts. The two biggest takeaways from this section should be: 1. If you're able to stay in either career for around 10 years, you'll be doing very well for yourself. And 2, while product managers make slightly less than software engineers on average, it does vary from company to company, and the difference is small enough that it shouldn't impact your decision. Focus more on the other aspects like job fulfillment, and you'll be much happier with your choice. This section is going to be relatively short, as there isn't a whole lot to discuss. While it varies significantly from company to company, most tech companies have a great work-life balance, and in either role, you're likely going to work between 40 and 50 hours per week, which for the amount they're compensated is extremely generous. Furthermore, many large companies offer benefits like gym memberships, healthcare plans, and more. And one of the largest benefits of working at tech companies is their remote work options, which have only become more prevalent after COVID. This doesn't really fluctuate between either role. The main difference in work-life balance between the two roles is based on job responsibilities. In software engineering, while you do work with others sometimes, you can largely work by yourself and not socialize as often, whereas product managers have to be very comfortable with communication to work with different teams. Also, because product managers are tied a lot more to the product's performance, there can sometimes be additional work as deadlines grow closer. But software engineers do face the same kind of challenges as they promote through the ranks. Ultimately, both roles have very similar work-life balances, and it's really more company-dependent than job-dependent. Lastly, on to market outlook. The market outlook for both careers is excellent right now, and demand for both software engineers and product managers is expected to grow in the coming years. As you've seen from above, market compensation is well above the average compared to other career paths, and these compensations have steadily been increasing year over year. During COVID-19, there was something that a lot of people are calling the Great Resignation, where a lot of people decided to take time off from work or change career paths entirely. For this reason, in 2022, companies are desperate for talent, and as software technology continues to grow, there has never been a better time to enter the workforce as a software engineer or a product manager. The one difference between the two roles in this regard is that there are a lot more job openings for software engineers than product managers. Most companies hire several software engineers for every one product manager, which means there are a lot less positions available in product management. With that being said, product management is also a lot less known and a lot less sought after than software engineering. So in my opinion, this causes the competition to level out quite a bit. But if it's just a matter of finding a job, software engineering does slightly edge out product management here. So, if there's one thing to take away from this video, it's that either career choice is excellent. They're well compensated, have great work-life balance, and have amazing career outlooks. So as long as you like technology, it's definitely worth going into. So, to answer the catch-all question, should you go into software engineering or product management? Well, the answer is always, it depends. I will give you a few scenarios where you might pick one over the other. While you can always change from one to the other, the truth is it's easier to go from software engineering to product management than the other way around. If you're a student fresh out of university and you know for a fact that you want to be a product manager, then go right into product management. But if you're unsure or thinking you might want to try out both, I would start off with software engineering. You can transition into product management later, and the software engineers will appreciate that you have some understanding of their work. Plus, the technical skills become harder to recalibrate later in your career if you haven't practiced them at all, although not impossible. So if you really do want to go from product management to software engineering, it is doable. Another scenario is if you love coding versus if you like doing various different things. If you love to code, go software engineering. If you kind of like coding, but you also want to do other things in your day-to-day work, try product management, especially technical product management at a company that requires their product managers to write a bit of code. Ultimately, you should just choose whichever path interests you more. If you want to learn more about software engineering and product management, subscribe to keep up to date with our channel's posts. We'll be posting videos for both career paths, as well as tutorials for coding and product management skills like design and customer discovery. If you liked this video, please leave a like and a comment, as well as some feedback as to what you liked. If you had any concerns, questions, or other feedback, please leave a comment below. We'll do our best to read and reply to each and every one. Thanks, and see you in the next video.